directions.
Hello friends, in today's video, we will see the map of India and identify the direction of states. Here are Raju and Govind who hail from Madhya Pradesh. Both of them are very excited about their school holidays.
Govind, in these holidays, I am going to Jammu and Kashmir with my parents. Oh wow! And I am going to Tamil Nadu with my family. All right. But where is Tamil Nadu? Look at this map carefully. Tamil Nadu is a southern state of India. And this is Jammu and Kashmir, where you are going for the holidays. Oh, Jammu and Kashmir and Tamil Nadu are in opposite directions. Yes, Raju. Jammu and Kashmir is in northern part of India. Not only this, do you know that the vast Himalayan mountain range is also in the northern part of India? And see this, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka, all these states are in the southern parts of India. Now can you tell me, by looking at the map of India, which states are in the east direction? Oh, that's very easy. By seeing the map, one can easily tell that Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal are in the east direction. Excellent, Raju. Now you are reading the map correctly. So does it mean that the states of Gujarat and Goa lie in the west direction? Yes, Raju, you are absolutely right.
So children, you just learned which states lie in four directions of India. But do you know that there are four additional directions besides these? Let's talk about them. There is one more direction in the middle of north and east. It is called northeast. Similarly, the direction in the middle of north and west is called northwest. The direction between south and east is called southeast. And the direction between south and west is called southwest. So children, that's all in today's video. But before I go, I will leave you with a question. By looking at the map, can you name three northeastern states of India? Bye friends!
About directions and their usage in reading of maps in this video today. One day, Bablu and Raju found the map of Champapur. They both were really excited about the map. Both Raju and Bablu started looking at their maps.
Raju, how interesting is this map? With this, we can find the way to any place in our village.
Yes, Bablu. See how the house of Khan is towards the south of your house.
How did you find that out, Bablu? And what does towards the south mean?
Oho, Bablu. Can't you spot the compass given on the map?
No. Where is that?
Then Raju took a look at Bablu's map.
Now I get it. There is no compass given on your map. But take a look. A compass like this is given on every map.
Saying this, Raju showed Bablu the compass drawn on his map.
But how are we supposed to use this? And what directions are these, Raju?
Then Raju explains it to him.
There are four cardinal directions: north, south, east and west, referred by north, by N, South by S, East by E, and West by W. They can be written like this too.
But how are we supposed to recognize these directions?
Now confused Bablu asks Raju.
This is very easy. Suppose you are looking at the direction where the sun rises. So you are looking towards the east direction. West will be towards your back. South would be towards your right hand. And the north would be towards your left hand.
But Raju, there is no sun shown on this map. Then how did you recognize the directions?
Look, this is called a compass. Using this, we can determine the directions on any map. There is an arrow like this on it. The head of it always points towards the north and end towards the south.
Towards the left of north is west.
And towards the right is the east direction.
Bablu gets really excited.
This is really interesting. Come on, Raju, let's play a game. You tell me the name of any place in the village and I will tell you it is in which direction from my house, okay?
Is that so? Then tell me, if you have to go to Golu's dairy from your house, you will go in which direction?
So this is my house and this is Golu's dairy. If the direction towards the front of my home is north and to left would be west direction. Golu's dairy is towards the west from my home. So to go there, I will go towards west.
Very nice, Bablu. This is absolutely correct. Now tell me, the well is towards which direction from my home?
This is your home. And this is the well. The well is above your home on the map, which means, according to the compass, the well is towards north from your house.
Bablu's answer is absolutely right. Kids, can you make use of the compass to complete the table? You can pause the video to find the answer. Very nice, kids. You have answered all of them absolutely right. Park is towards south of the pond. Jungle is towards east of the park. Meenu's house is in the north of Raju's house. And Uncle's house is on the west of Raju's house. Raju and Bablu are playing their interesting game. You too can play it with your friends using the map of Champapur, making questions of your own about directions. So kids, in this video, we learned about directions and the use of the compass. This video today, we will learn more about reading a map. Everyone from school went on a trip. But being sick, Chanda could not go on the trip. While returning, Appu brings for Chanda a map of that place. He wanted to tell Chanda about what he saw there. Appu goes to Chanda's house and now he's showing her the map. He told her that at first the bus stopped at the parking. Since the journey was a long one, so everyone was hungry. So they started looking for a canteen. Kids, can you tell towards which direction is the canteen from the parking? Absolutely correct.
towards the north. Kids, can you see the compass that is made on the map? Everyone walked towards the north and reached the canteen. There, they had some delicious food. Some of them went towards the cricket ground and some came to the library to check out the exhibition. Chanda was surprised to see the cricket ground on the map. She told Golu how the library looked much smaller than the cricket ground. So can he tell her the area of the cricket ground is how many times that of the library? Come, let's help Chanda to find the answer. Kids, do you remember the process of finding the area of any given place using the method of squares? In this process, we can find the area of any given place using the number of similar squares that the respective place has. If we look at the cricket ground, it is made of 12 squares, while the library is made of only 4 squares. So, in this way, the area of the cricket ground is 12 square centimeter, while the area of the library is 4 square centimeter. So, now can you tell how many times is the area of the cricket ground more than the area of the library? You can pause the video to find the answer. Absolutely correct, children. The area of the cricket ground is 3 times the area of the library. Chanda is surprised to know how big the cricket ground is. Golu tells her that there is another place bigger than the cricket stadium and asks Chanda to tell the name of the place whose area is the biggest. Kids, can you also find that place with Chanda? That's correct. The area of the garden is the biggest. Chanda tells Golu that she can spot roads everywhere. There is at least one road near every place. Then Golu tells her there is one place besides which there is no road. Can you find that place on the map? That's right. There is no road near the pond. Golu tells Chanda that they played the game of hide and seek too. Golu was hiding behind the gate of the playground and Sher Khan was hiding in the place right in front. Can you tell which was the place where Sher Khan was hiding? Absolutely correct. Right in front of the playground is the park. Sher Khan was hiding inside the park. Chanda also felt as if she had gone to the trip too. For this, she thanked Golu a lot. Kids, you can pause the video and play the game of question answers with your friends too. Kids, in this video, we learned about reading a map. Children, in this lesson, we will learn about the scales on maps. For Tufan Tortoise's birthday, Babble Duck Uncle sent some sweets with Golu Panda. Uncle gave Golu a map from his house to Tufan Tortoise's house, which was marked with a dotted line. Can you tell through which places will Golu pass on the way? If you want, you can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Great, kids!
Your answer is absolutely correct. Golu went on his way. After a while, he got lost. That's when he saw Meenu on the way. He asked Meenu for directions. As soon as Meenu saw the map, she told Golu that he would have to go about 4 kilometers more. Golu was shocked to hear this. He told Meenu that he had walked 1 centimeter on road number 1 as per the map given by uncle. But he could not see Appu's confectionery far and wide. Meenu then draws Golu's attention to the scale written on the map. On the scale, it was written 1 centimeter equals 2 kilometer. What is this? Is this a scale? What is a scale? Children, have you seen a map? Do you know about the scale on the map? Meenu is explaining to Golu that because in reality paths are really long, we cannot show their length on a small paper. Therefore, we use scale. As written on this map, 1 centimeter equals 2 kilometer. What could it mean? This means that 1 centimeter of map is equal to 2 kilometers on the earth. Do you know how we can use this scale? The distance of road number 1 on the map given by uncle is 2 centimeter. How many kilometer on earth is 1 centimeter according to scale written on the map? 2 kilometer. What is the distance of road number 1 in this way? 2 times 2 equals 4 kilometer. Golu is happy and at the same time sad about the scale because he would have to walk far enough to reach Appu's confectionery shop. Walking on road number 1, Golu finally reached Appu's confectionery. He bought sweets from there for Tufan. Can you tell which road Golu will have to walk next? Look at the map and tell. Alright, Golu now has to go to road number 2. Now can you tell the distance of road number 2 using the scale on the map? You can find the answer by pausing the video. Kids, your answer is absolutely correct. The distance of road number 2 is 8 km. Here the distances of all the roads coming in the way of Golu are shown in centimeter. Now, can you identify the longest road on the way? Now use the scale to tell the distance in kilometer of the longest road. You can pause the video and find the answer. Yes, your answer is absolutely correct. Road number 6 is the longest road and its distance is 10 kilometer. Will Golu get lost ever again? What will happen with Golu? We will see in next video. Children, in this lesson, we learned about the scale on the maps. In the previous lesson, we learned about how to use a scale on the maps to read direction. No. If we reach a point, how will we decide which path to go? To know this, we have to know about right and left direction. In this lesson, we will learn about the right and left directions used in maps. In previous lesson, Golu had bought sweets for Tufan from Appu's confectionery. Now, Golu again started with his journey. After going some distance, he saw the board of road number 3 on the road. He was shocked. According to uncle's map, he should have been on road number 2. So where did Golu make a mistake this time? Golu was to go right on road number 2 from Appu's confectionery. But he took a left turn from Appu's shop, which was road number 3. Kids, do you know how to identify right and left directions? The direction that comes to your right-hand side is called right-hand side. And the direction that comes towards your left hand, we call it left-hand side. Do you want to learn an easy process of identifying the right hand and the left hand? The left hand starts with the letter L and hence denoted with L. Keep your hand like this. Now, the hand whose thumb and index finger is making the letter L is your left hand. And the other one is right. Let us understand this with another example. Suppose Golu stands here and has a bucket on one side and a ball on the other side. Now, how will Golu identify which side is the bucket on and which side is the ball on which side of his hand? It is very easy. By the process that we learned, Golu would raise both his hands in this way. Now can you tell which hand is making letter L? Yes, with this hand. So, which hand of Golu is this? Alright, left hand. And this hand? Right hand. So, which side of hand does Golu have the ball? Left hand. And the bucket? On his right hand. After looking for the way, Golu finally reached road number 2. Walking straight on road number 2, he is now standing at such a fork end of the road. Can you see the map and tell which road Golu has to take next? Yes, Golu will now have to go to road number 5. Can we tell from the process we learned that to get to road number 5, Golu has to turn right or left? If you want, you can pause the video and find the answer to this question. Well done, kids. You have found the right answer. Road number 5 is on the right-hand side of Golu, so he will have to turn right to go to road number 5. Golu has now started walking on road number 5. Reaching the end of this road, he went to the left and the last route of his journey. The road started at number 6. Children, can you look at the map and tell that from where will Golu pass on the road number 6? Which side of Golu will this place be? Find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Absolutely right. Walking on road number 6, Golu will pass next to the post box. The post box will be on his left hand side. Walking straight on road number 6, Golu finally reached Tufan's house. He gave Tufan the box of sweets that uncle sent and also gave him lots of birthday wishes. Children, in this lesson, we have learned about the right and left directions using maps. Children, in this lesson, we will see use of scale and direction in the maps. One day, Bablu reached the village of Ulta Pulta. As soon as he reached the gate to go inside, he found a map which was upside down. Bablu was extremely naughty. He immediately went inside the village, but there was nobody in Ulta Pulta village. He got a little scared and wanted to come out of the same gate where he entered from, but it was closed. Then he recalled that he has a map of the Ulta Pulta village, but Bablu did not know how to read the map. Can you help Bablu to get out of the Ulta Pulta village? Pause the video and look for a way to get out of the village. Absolutely right. Bablu can use any of these routes to get out of the Ulta Pulta village. Here, the length of paths of Ulta Pulta village is written in centimeters. If Bablu is standing near the gate going in, so can you find the shortest way to get out of it using the scale written on the map? How long is this road? You can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Yes, by using way 1. We can take Bablu out of the village of Ulta Pulta by the shortest route. We add the length of these 4 roads. How many centimeters will we get? 13 centimeter. Can you really tell the distance by looking at the scale written on this map? You can think by pausing the video if you want. 1 centimeter of map is equal to 5 kilometer on the earth. Therefore, how many kilometer will 13 centimeter be? 13 times 5, that is 65 kilometer. The length of the shortest route actually is 65 kilometer. Bablu was going towards the shortest path mentioned by us when suddenly he was pulled towards road number 3, towards the magical well. Now, if Bablu has 2 exit routes, are these 2 paths at equal distance? Find an answer to this question by pausing the video. Absolutely right. Both paths are exactly at the same distance. The total distance on the map is 16 centimeter. So the actual distance would be 16 multiplied by 5. That is 80 kilometer. Now Bablu tried to go out of road number 3. If Bablu is on road number 4, then which side is the magical tree? The magical tree is on the left-hand side of Bablu, which means it would be on the left. Bablu crossed road number 4 in fear and also walked on road number 5 and has come to an end of it. Now Bablu is thinking which way he has to turn. Can you tell us which direction Bablu has to turn from the unique cave to road number 6? Absolutely right. Towards left. Bablu ran fast and crossed road number 6. Now, which road will he take after turning right? Road number 7. Bablu crossed road number 7 from the spot and reached the exit gate. Bablu came out of the gate and regained his strength. Kids, Bablu is thanking you for helping him. Children, in this lesson, we have seen the use of scales and directions in maps. what are floor maps and their deep drawings. And how can they be made? Learn about this. One day, the king announced that he had to change the design of his room. Whoever makes the best design for their room will be rewarded. The very first day, Bunny reached first to the king with a floor map to renovate his room. The floor map looked like this. Kids, do you know about a map of the floor? From the map of the floor of a room or the house, we can find out where the windows and doors are in it. Can you tell by looking at the map of the floor how many windows are there? Yes, the floor map has 5 windows. Is there any window on the wall that has a door? Exactly. There is no window in the wall where the door is. How many walls does this room have? Right. This room has 10 walls. How many walls are there in this room with no windows? There are 5 walls with no windows. The king liked the floor map that Bunny had made, but could not find out how the room would look like and how high the windows would be from the map of the floor of Bunny. So he did not reward Bunny. Bunny was returning home with a sad face when he saw Bhola the donkey on the way. Bhola asked the reason for Bunny being depressed. Bunny told him the whole story. Bhola told Bunny that he could help him. Bunny was shocked. Bhola asked Bunny to show the map of the floor and asked him to come with him to the king's court the next day. The next day, Bhola and Bunny reached the king's court. Bhola showed the king such a picture of his room design. Bunny and the king were shocked to see the picture. Children, have you seen any picture similar to this one created by Bhola? Can you tell the difference between two pictures that Bhola and Bunny made? Correct. The floor map that Bunny had made is a two-dimensional figure, which has only length and the breadth of the room. That's why we cannot tell about the height of the room or the window. This portrait is depicting all three dimensions. In this, we can also see the length, breadth, and depth of the room. And that's how we can tell about the height of the room or window from the picture that Bhola had made. Since we can also estimate the depth, we call the pictures drawn by Bhola as deep drawings. Here are the pictures of the room Bhola and Bunny made. Can you tell which windows of the room are not visible in Bhola's picture? If you want, you can pause the video and find the answer to this question. Absolutely right. These windows are not seen in Bhola's pictures. Can Bhola make this deep drawing in any other way? You can try to make such a picture in your notebook by pausing the video. Bhola can also make a deep drawing of the room in this way. Children, can you tell what is the difference between these two deep drawings? Actually, this picture is made by looking at the room from the front, while this deep picture is made by looking at the room from the right side. we can see any three-dimensional objects from different views. We will learn about it in the next video. The king liked the design made by Bhola, but he wanted to see some more designs by different people. The next day, Chanda and Babul Uncle Duck reached the king's court with their floor map and deep drawings. Can you mix floor maps with the deep drawings? You can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Well done, kids! Your answer is absolutely right. The king saw many more designs, but out of all, he liked Bhola's design the best. At last, the king rewarded Bhola. Bhola immediately gave half of it to Bunny, because he made that deep drawing by looking at the map of the floor made by Bhola. Children, in this video, we learned about the map of the floor and what are deep drawings.
Children, in the last video, we learned about making deep drawings of houses and rooms. In this video, we will see interesting examples of making deep drawings of some other shapes. Today, a drawing competition has been organized in Champapur. Everyone is ready with paper and pencil. Babban, the director of the competition, said that they can draw any shape. The person who creates the most beautiful picture will win a prize. Everyone started drawing their own pictures. Time ran out and everyone gave their pictures to Babban. Let's see who has made what kind of picture. Children, can you take a look at these pictures and tell us which of these pictures that you see in front of you looks like a deep drawing of a shape of a cube? Yes, Chanda's picture is a deep drawing of a cube. Because Chanda's portrait was the most beautiful, Chanda won the prize. Everyone is asking Chanda how she made a deep drawing of a cube so easily. Do you also want to learn this? Come, let us all learn to draw a deep drawing of a cube from Chanda. Chanda drew four vertical lines like this on a paper first. Then she connected the ends of those lines like this. It became a deep drawing of a cube. Isn't it easy? Can you make a deep drawing of a cube in some other way? You can try making it in your notebook by pausing the video. Children, you can also make a deep drawing of the cube in this way. Chanda went straight to her friend Appu Elephant's house with the trophy she won at the competition. Appu congratulated her on winning the competition. Now they are both playing a game. Chanda has made a cube net in this way on a cardboard. Appu has to make its deep drawing. Can you tell what this deep drawing will look like? You can find the answer by pausing the video. You can make this deep drawing in this way too. Chanda made a dice by folding a net made of paper. And Chanda and Appu started playing their game. Children, you can now play a game of making a deep drawing of a cuboid with your friends. If you want, you can stop the video and make it. Children, you can make a deep drawing of a cuboid in this way. Children, in this video, we saw some interesting examples of making deep drawings of shapes like cube and cuboid.